स्टार्ट हो गया ना।
अस्सलाम वालेकुम, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अपर एंड लोअर साइड फ्रीक्वेंसी। इन अपर एंड लोअर साइड फ्रीक्वेंसी द सिग्नल इन द मॉड्यूलेटेड एंड अनमॉड्यूलेटेड सिग्नल दैट इज the carrier wave signal having the frequency fc, whereas the modulating signal mean over signal, mean over voice, over video, audio signal which we want to transfer from one place to another place is having the frequency FM. So when this FC, wave frequency FC combined with over signal, that is the modulating signal, the heterodynamic action take place. Heterodynamic functions mean when the carrier waves combined with the modulating signal, say as a result, the two additional frequencies, produce. Which is called the upper side frequencies and the lower side frequencies. These are upper side frequency and lower side frequency. Upper side frequency is abbreviated by USF, where lower side frequency is represented by the abbreviation LSF. So with the combination of these two waves, carrier waves and modulating waves, we have the two frequency sides. One is the upper side frequency and the lower side frequency, and this amplitude modulated signal, now the signal is modulated. Now this modulated signal have three functions. What are these? Amplitude modulation is found to consist of three frequencies components. One is the original carrier frequency, carrier wave. Carrier frequency component, that is FC. Number two, the higher frequency, component, it is FC plus FM, or it is also called the sum component. It is also called sum component. The lower frequency component, that is FC minus FM, and it is also called the difference component. Because it is the minus of FC from FM, FM is the frequency of overmodulating signal, FC is the frequency of the carrier wave signal. So each modulated signal consists of these three major components. One is the original carrier wave, other is the high frequency component, that is the sum component, and the third is the lower frequency component, that is the difference component. And we can see from the figure here that our signal, if let's suppose our signal is represented like this, it has the voltage is 1 volt, from 0 to 1 volt or from 0 to minus 1 volt. Okay, so the carrier waves, which are constant around our these are present around having this frequency, which is frequency is constant, and the amplitude is also constant, and the carrier waves is represented just like this. These are the continuous wave and higher frequency wave signal which are present in our environment. Okay, this is the carrier waves. If the voltage is from 0 to, if the amplitude is from 0 to 1.5 volt, and the modulating signal, that is the voice, having an amplitude from 1 volt, 0 to 1 volt, and the higher frequency signal, that is the carrier waves, having the voltage from 0 to 1.4, then the modulated signal. The modulated signal, when we combine this FC with this FM, so we will have the signal like this. This is just replica over our signal, and the carrier wave or the high frequency wave will be enveloped or packed in the signal, in our signal. These are enveloped. Okay, like this. So here the magnitude will be 2.5 volt. You can see the magnitude or the maximum value of our modulating signal is 1 volt, whereas the amplitude of the carrier wave is 1.5 volt. The summation of two, when both are combined, the amplitude will be 2.5 volt, where it is started from 0.5 volt from 0 to this. And similarly here at the negative end, this is minus 2.5 volt. So you can see our modulating signal remains unchanged because the amplifier offers a very low impedance or very low resistance to this volt, a very low impedance or very low resistance to this. This is our signal or modulating signal is a very low frequency. Here, that's the frequency of this carrier wave is very high, and the signal and the frequency of this, what is the frequency? The cycles per second, cycle passing through per second, number of cycles per second. You can see here is only one cycle in the time zone. This is the time zone. Here your number of cycles is very high, so this is the high frequency wave, and this is a low frequency range. So amplifiers will not affect or will not offer the impedance to this low frequency signal. So amplifier does not offer any or any reactance or any impedance to this. So we will get such type of, this is the modulated signal. Modulated signal. Now how we can represent these three components in this wave? So this frequency, these component, this is the original carrier waves by the here. This is the signal of the carrier waves, which has a very high frequency FC, and this is the upper side band that is represented by FM plus FC plus FM, and this is F minus FM. This is the lower side frequency, and this is the upper side frequency. This is the sum component because FC is plus with FM. Here the LC is minus FM. This is the lower side frequency, this is the upper side frequency. And the amplitude of this signal is depends upon the amplitude of the it may be represented as M is equal to M A divided by 2, where A is the amplitude of modulating signal. So modulating signal, the amplitude divided by 2, because it is a two frequency and they are symmetrically distributed around B. Okay. A is the amplitude of the carrier waves. Now the next topic is upper side and the and lower side frequency. Upper side and lower side frequency bands. What is meant by band? Band mean when the carrier waves, as we have read before, here is the carrier wave frequency. And this is the upper side frequency and this is the lower side frequency, which is represented by FC plus FM and it is represented by FC minus FM. Okay, this is very simple and it was assumed in the beginning. We can assumed that modulating signal FM modulating signal of was composed of single frequency. Okay, that is FM, only the single frequency. But in broadcasting, we know when the broadcasting is occur in broadcasting station. In broadcasting station, what happened? The modulating signal is the human voice modulating signal, or the signal which is broadcasting is the modulating signal is human voice. Okay, our voice is broadcast by the different station. So we know that human has the two frequency, one is the upper frequency and the other is the lower frequency, and this has a range of voice from 20 to 4000 hertz. So it means any voice, any signal which we want to propagate from one place to another place having a frequency range from the lower to the upper. So each of these waves has each wave of human voice has its own upper and lower frequency. Upper and lower frequency sides. So when all these frequencies, one has a frequency, mean it has upper frequency and it is a lower scale, otherwise has an upper frequency, and similarly there are many modulating signal which has their own upper frequency and their own lower frequency. So the we will get a band of the upper frequency. Okay, similarly that frequency which has the upper frequency here, which has the lower frequency here, which has an upper frequency in the next, in the then the lower frequency is here. So similarly, we will get the lower frequency band and the this is the band which cover a particular range of the frequency. This is called the upper frequency band, and this is called, this region is called the lower frequency band. Okay. So similarly, or it is also called the lower side band and upper side band. Okay. Lower side band and the upper side band. Similarly, we can see here that there are two limits. One is, this is the maximum limit in the negative direction, and here FC minus FM has the maximum limit, minimum limit, because it is towards the negative direction. Here this point will indicate FC plus FM, and this next FC plus FM, this is minimum, and this is maximum for the positive component. Now how we can find the channel width? The channel width is the distance from this point to this point. This is the channel width. So how we can find the channel width? It is the difference channel width. It is the difference between the extreme position extreme frequency, that is two extreme frequencies, that is the upper difference between the upper frequencies of the positive factor component and the minimum, and the minimum between FC minus FM. So this difference will give the channel width, frequencies, that is difference between maximum frequency of upper side band and minimum frequency of lower side band. So this from this topic we have learned how the bands and how we can find the channel width. Now the next is the mathematical analysis of modulated carrier waves. Mathematical analysis of modulated carrier waves. Now the equation of unmodulated carrier waves, the signal that is represented by the carrier waves, you can see here this type of the signal is, which has a very high frequency, is the carrier. We can write this carrier wave in the form of the equation of modulated carrier wave is EC is equal to EC sine of 2 pi FCT. and it can also write EC is the amplitude of the current wave. So it can be represented by A, the sine of 2 pi FCT. And we also know that A sine of 2 pi FCT is represented by NT, that is EC. Where A is the amplitude of the carrier wave, A is the amplitude of carrier wave. So similarly, let the equation of single frequency modulated signal, let the equation of single frequency modulating signal is given by EM, that is EM sine of 2 pi FM and T, and we can also represent it as B sine of 2 pi FM T. So as we have replaced 2 pi FC with omega, omega is equal to 2 pi FC. So here we can also B sine of PT, mean place P, any variable, replace FM, 2 pi FM. So to make the expression simple, as this figure you can see from the modulated signal that here the zero, and this is the amplitude of the carrier wave, and this is the amplitude of your signal. Okay, so at this any point, if this is the amplitude, instantaneous amplitude, that is represented by EM, this is your modulation. Okay, so the amplitude which is represented, the maximum amplitude of your modulating signal is B, and this is the amplitude of the carrier wave. Carrier wave have the amplitude, as you know, A is the modulating amplitude of the carrier waves. These are the carrier waves. When the carrier waves mix with the modulating signal, so this type of the amplitude waves can be obtained. So by adding this, what will be the signal or the amplitude of the modulated signal? Mean after the combination of both carrier waves and plus the modulating signal over voice. So it become modulated. Okay, so this become the modulated signal. This is the amplitude of the carrier wave plus the amplitude of your modulating signal. So on the whole, it becomes the modulated signal. So the modulated signal has the amplitude. The amplitude of the modulated carrier wave at any instant will be written as, by the combination of both signal, amplitude of modulated signal at any instant become A plus EM. From this figure you can see A is the amplitude of, EM is the amplitude of your modulated signal, that becomes the amplitude of the modulated signal, mean the resultant signal. Okay, you can substitute their values. A, that is the B sine of PT, has the instantaneous value is given by E. Any instantaneous value, that is the combination of both. A, sorry, here is the plus. So it becomes A plus B sine of PT. By substituting this amplitude in the carrier wave signal, that is the first expression, when there is omega T. We have the first notation, that is EC. C is equal to A sine of omega T. Okay, this is this EC. A mean the total amplitude A plus B sine of omega T. So A plus B sine of omega T, the value of this is substituted in place of this A, the amplitude of modulated signal, and sine omega T is placed here. So we have obtained this expression. Now by solving this expression, we obtain E is equal to A plus B T sine, sorry, here is P omega T. Okay, so open this expression, A sine of omega T plus B sine of P T sine of omega T. So if we divide it with 2, mean B by 2 and multiply by 2, then we can convert to half angle formula this expression. So A sine of omega T plus B by 2, that is this 2 sine PT, 2 sine omega T, theta 1, theta 2. Sine of theta 1, sine of theta 2 can be written as cos of omega minus P T plus cos of omega plus P T. Okay. So this is the trigonometric formula of sine, conversion of sine into the cos sine, cos theta, sorry.
Cos theta, sorry.
A sine of omega T plus B by 2 cos of omega minus P T minus
Marty.
Here is minus B by 2 cos of omega plus P T. So we can place here the value of omega, which we have mentioned before, A sine of, by substituting omega, that become 2 pi fc t plus B by 2 cos of omega has 2 pi fc and p has 2 pi fm. So we can take 2 pi common and fc minus fm. Similarly here, b by 2 cos of omega. So 2 pi is common. Here is fc and p into pi fm. So 2 pi mean 2 pi, we have taken the 2 pi common. So here plus fm t. Here also T. So it's mean we know that this expression has mainly three components. First component and the third component. It's mean first component is only have a factor FC. It's mean it is totally the carrier wave. The second component you know FC minus FM. That is the lower frequency limit. So this is the lower frequency limit. or and the next is FC plus FM, that is the high frequency limit. So it's mean over signal, mean such type of the signal that we have drawn before, FC and FM plus FC, and here FM minus FC. So it's mean the modulated signal. We have proved from this equation that the modulated signals has three components. One is the component of FC, that is the modulated carrier waves, and the upper high limit of the is FM plus FC and FM minus FC. It is proof from this equation. So we know that M, that is the percentage modulation, that is equal to B. B is equal to MA. So by substituting the value of B, M by A, in this equation, we will get the equation here. Take sine of 2 pi FC T plus M A divided by 2, that is the value of B. In this equation, B is equal to M A divided by 2 cos of 2 pi minus F M T. And the second component, this B by 2, we have replaced B with MA divided by 2 cos of F C plus F M. So this is the first component, this is the second component, and this is the third component of the modulated signal. So it is observed that modulated wave consists of modulated signal consists of three components. Number one, A sine of 2 pi FC T, that is the carrier wave. Number 2, MA divided by 2 cos of 2 pi FC minus FM T. This is the lower frequency limit. And the third one, MA divided by 2 cos of 2 pi FC plus FM. This is the upper frequency band. Frequency limit. Okay? So we can see that we can see this from the figure here. If we have a wave, modulating wave, as we have drawn before, this is the modulating wave. That is, first, these are the carrier waves, that is very high frequency wave, having the same amplitude, and FC plus FM, that has FC, this is FC, high frequency band, And here the FM, that is the very close band and very small band, and its amplitude is m by 2, the half. And here the low frequency band, which is separated by a little bit higher distance, and here the amplitude is m by 2. So its half amplitude is using in modulated signal. Okay, I think it is clear, and you have noted this, and read it carefully, and then let me know in the very much.